The views expressed on the following program do not necessarily reflect the views of Money Radio staff, management, or advertisers, and do not represent an offer to buy or sell any securities. Some interviews heard on this program may be sponsored by the participants. It's time for Health Futures with Cypress Home Care Solutions, Bob Roth. This is Arizona's only show dedicated to providing you with expert advice on how to live a longer, healthier, and happier life. To learn more, call 602-264-8009. That's 602-264-8009. Now, here's your host, Bob Roth.
Good afternoon. You're listening to Health Futures, taking stock in you. I'm your host, Bob Roth, and it must be Friday, and indeed it is. We're coming at you live from the Scottsdale Air Park Money Radio Studios, 1510 AM, 105.3 FM, and the World Wide Web, moneyradio1510.com. If this is the first time you're tuning into our show is about how our older adult population can live a healthier, happier life. How do they do that? Not by listening to me, it's by listening to these extraordinary guests that I have on the show, and today's no different. I am really pleased to have, coming in through technology, the phone lines, I've got Ellen Goodwin. She is the co-founder and chief solutions officer of a company called Artifcts, and I want to spell it. It's A-R-T-I-F-C-T-S. Welcome to the show, Ellen.
Hello, Bob. It's a pleasure to be here. Thanks for having me.
It's good to have you. It's so great to hear your voice. It's been a little while. How you been?
It has. We've been well. We're hot, as you can imagine, in Austin, Texas, as you've been experiencing as well.
Yes, we have. I can't begin to tell you how many days of 110-plus degrees we've had here. It's been quite a lot. But you know what? I know that fall is right around the corner. I think they were playing football yesterday. The Hall of Fame game was last week. So.
Oh, I saw that. That's right.
Yeah. So it's just right around the corner. But
it's promising.
Ellen, it's so great to have you here on the show. And you provide an incredible service to the aging community. I mean, the community at large because of the work you do. So, you know, I kicked it off by saying, you have this company called Artifcts, and it's a consumer platform, website, app. And I'm looking at your website, and I love the line that you have up there. It's, hello there. Got stuff? Got stuff? You know, you and I have had a chance to get to know one another, but I'm going to ask you more in the second segment to tell me a little bit about your background. But tell me about Artifcts and Got Stuff.
Oh, it's my pleasure. I mean, the reality is we all have got stuff, and what we've really set out here to do is not only capture the stories and memories, which frankly are quite critical, but to deal with all of the stuff that we collect and accumulate in life. Because otherwise, our observation was it becomes a burden, right? Whether it's now because we're storing it and we're moving it all over the country, or someday when we're no longer here and it becomes something for our loved ones to sort through in their grief and figure out what to do with. And we wanted to figure out a way to turn that on the head and say, okay, how can we take that moment, appreciate why we have these things, what they mean to us, and make better use of that, whether it's because we can connect, because we can share the stories and memories, or maybe lock in what the financial value of it is to ourselves. But we needed to have a solution that could make it just as wicked easy as social media, but have something more valuable and private and in your own control to capture those stories and memories behind life's objects.
You know, I know many of our listeners are listening in, and I'm actually hosting this show, and I have shared with you personally how I have accumulated stuff from both my mom, who passed almost 22 years ago, and my dad just little less than a year ago. And I didn't get the stories. You know, I got these pictures. Mm-hmm. I've got this art. And, you know, some of them I do. They're people in these pictures. Some, you know, I don't have a clue who they are, and I have no one to know who to ask. And then, you know, I as along with my family members, have acquired some of the sculptures and paintings and things. And every one of those has a story, doesn't it, Elle?
Oh, absolutely. And that's the thing, right? You're what we like to call a family keeper. You're the person who has acquired a lot of life's objects and heirlooms, collectibles, and you're sitting there and you're looking at it and you're not going to be able to keep it all forever. And you really wish you could have that person and what all of that meant. And that's what we run into over and over again. And, you know, frankly, that whole expression, a photo's worth a thousand words, is one of our pet peeves here at Artifcts, because I'm sorry, but, you know, if you don't have the story behind the photo, they can't talk. We can now animate them, right? We can
right.
do interesting things like that. We can restore and animate, but if the story's gone, it's gone. And not a lot of people have the time or interest, frankly, to try and chase all those histories. They're kind of prone to giving up, and that's too bad, because you lose a lot of your loved ones that way, and you want to remember them.
And for me, you know, we, and for our listeners who are just tuning in, we run a home care agency. We're in our 30th year, and we provide in-home care supportive services. And a lot of times, the work that we're doing is more on the companionship level. And certainly, you know, when family members aren't here, they're in other states, or maybe even other countries, you know, it's a great way to have a activity to do, where you can not only pull a lot of this stuff together, but you can utilize the tools that Artifcts have so you can memorialize them. And you and I have talked about this, and intentionally we're working on trying to get a few of our clients on board so we can do this. What a great activity this could be for caregivers.
Oh, it absolutely is. I mean, look, it's one of those activities that keeps on giving, right? So you do it and you get to know each other better, the caregiver and the person, without kind of one of those upfront interviews, not answer 20 questions. But it's a more comfortable way to get to know each other. And then you have the reward and that extra benefit of being able to share these Artifcts with the family. And they're going to have a lot of those, I never knew that about you, kind of moments in the process. And that's the beauty of it. And it's something that translates across generations too, right? And that is another exceptional benefit of doing this is, you know, you might not be ready for the story this moment, but it's going to be there when you're ready for it.
And what's interesting is I know our caregivers are doing some of this, but what they're doing, mm-hmm. what they're doing is they're not memorializing it. They don't have the tools. Mm-hmm. And that's where you guys come into play. And, you know, I'm going to tell you, Alan, you and I have gotten to know each other over the last couple of years, and I haven't had a chance to speak to you in a little while. I'm so glad that we've got you here on the show. We have four segments, and our segments run really, really fast. So as we get to conclude this first segment, can you give me a sense of how is this done with Artifcts? How do you help these individuals and these families memorialize it?
Yep. Let me, cut to the chase, right? So you create a membership. You can use our app. You can use our website, wherever you're comfortable. And it's super simple. You can take a photo or use a photo that's already on your phone or a video or audio segment, and you share it to the app or to our website, and you fill in the title. You give it a little bit of description. You can tell a story. You can give 5 words. My dad gave this to me. Or it could be a whole saga, whatever it is. We don't want to create a story burden, but just tell us what it means to you. Pick a category. This is art. This is a memento. This is travel stuff. This is wine. This is jewelry, whatever. And click save. And then you have in your private Artifcts collection this object with its story and photo and video that might relate to it. And you can decide what to do with it next after that. You can share it with friends and family. You can share it with circles that you create on Artifcts privately, and you can all swap Artifcts. But the point is, it's that simple. Pick an object, take a picture of it, add a few details and
hit save.
That's it.
And the video too. So it's not just a picture. So
yes.
you can capture video, and you can capture present video, or can you capture recorded mm-hmm. video that, you know, maybe know, your grandparents or your parents' wedding and stuff like that. You can do that as well.
Oh, absolutely. Wow. One of my personal favorites, and I've been asked to record this, so I better do it and share it publicly. But one of my favorite Artifcts is something minor. It's a family recipe for a coffee cake that we would make every Christmas. And I tell the story of making this coffee cake and bringing it to my family in Chicago. But I have a picture of the actual recipe card in my mother's handwriting. And I also have a video, and it's her. It's just a little snippet of my mother teaching my daughter how to make the coffee cake via Zoom during COVID.
Whoa.
So in one artifact, I have the story, I have the recipe, and I have my mom.
Wow. That is so cool. And the fact that you have her demonstrating on how to prepare that recipe.
Yeah.
That makes it even more special.
Absolutely. No secrets. We know the tricks to the recipe.
We do. Well, as you can hear the music, the music takes us out and it brings us in. So we're down one segment. We've got three more to go. And, you know, Ellen, when we come back, I'd love for you to share with you, with me and our listeners, your background and how you came to create Artifcts. Sound like a deal?
My pleasure.
Deal. You're listening to Health Futures Taking Stock in You. I'm your host, Bob Roth. I've got Ellen Goodwin here in the studio with me from a company called Artifcts. We got a lot more to cover. Stick around. We'll be right back.
Now back to Health Futures. Taking stock in you. If you have questions about your own or your loved one's future healthcare, call 602-264-8009. Now, here's your host, Cypress Home Care Solutions, Bob Roth.
Welcome back. You're listening to Health Futures Taking Stock in You. I'm your host, Bob Roth, and we are in our second segment here. And if you're just tuning in, I've got Ellen Goodwin. She's the co-founder and chief solution officer for a company called Artifcts. I want to spell it out because I want you all to know how to get to it. It's Artifcts. And if you want to find it on the website, go to artifcts.com. And when we talked about it before, the first screen that comes up, it says, "You got stuff?" Right, Ellen? You got stuff?
That's right. We all do, right?
We do. But, you know, I want our listeners to know a little bit about you because every one of us has a great story, just like what you want to do is help people tell their stories. You have a fascinating story, and I know there's probably some that you can share and some that you really can't because of your background, but I'm always intrigued how people get into certain, you know, verticals, certain businesses, and your story is a great story. So if you would indulge me and our listeners, tell us a little bit about you.
Thanks, Bob. I mean, it is a bit unconventional. I will agree to have two female co-founders of a patented consumer tech company that comes from the CIA, not the culinary one, but the U.S. Central Intelligence Agency. And that's where I met my co-founder, Heather Nickerson. We went to training together, actually, at the CIA when we first went in 2006. And because we were in the same training program for many months together, we got to know each other and stayed close. And our careers kind of paralleled in some ways. We're both intelligence briefers. So we both took a rotation to brief policymakers, and I'd like to joke that, you know, mine was in cozy Washington, D.C. with a cabinet official, and hers was in the wonderland that is Kabul, Afghanistan. So our experience is a little different, but, you know, we both enjoyed getting out there and talking with people and understanding problems and trying to really communicate what matters most. And I think that story element is something that resonates here, but also the security and privacy is something we take very seriously. And when we decided to build Artifcts, you know, security and privacy had to come first, right? This wasn't going to be a social media rerun. We like to call it human media 1.0 because everything's private by default. We don't sell your data. We don't have advertisements. And we did that very intentionally because these stories and moments of your lives and the objects that represent them, they're very personal. It's a very intimate experience that we wanted to offer. And Heather and I both, you know, after the CIA, she went into security and privacy. She wrote a book on privacy. And I went into data technology. And so when Heather's mother passed away very unexpectedly, Heather found herself with a 6,000 square foot house full of stuff in Cape Cod and no idea what any of it was. Mm. The memories, you know, all of it was lost with her mother. And her brother said, yeah, not it. We're not going to figure this all out, but don't get rid of anything important. Wait, what is important? How do you know if it's just a piece of jewelry or it's a family heirloom? Like, how do you know?
Right.
And it was too late. And Heather did not want that trauma, that burden, and that grief to happen to others. And so we brought it together for Artifcts.
You know, I know we're using phones to come in, and I don't know if you're moving around a little bit, but wherever you were about 2 minutes ago, it was perfect. So I just wanted you to know they got a little choppy there at the very end. But I got it, and I do want to share with our listeners, Ellen and I and our mutual friend Danny were walking the streets in Denver, and I'll never forget, we were going to this one restaurant. Instead of taking an Uber, we were like, yeah, let's go and walk. So we took like a mile walk, and we were going by some areas that were a little, as my kids would say, sketchy. And, you know, I hope I'm not sharing too much yet. You know, you're about my wife's height, maybe 100 pounds. And I'm like, I knew your background, and I was like, we're passing some of these undesirables. And I'm like, I know I'm going to be safe because I got Ellen with me. She's CIA trained. So she's got my back. She's definitely got my back. But your story, more important, Heather's story, is one that so many people have. And I've not had the pleasure of meeting Heather, but I've read a lot about her on your website. And I know her story's, you know, very similar to yours, but also different, too. And you have the opportunity to do some memorializing with your mom, and she totally missed that window. And I know that she probably lives with regret, but that was really the impetus and the passion that drove her to really help form Artifcts with you. So I love when people have missions and they're mission-driven. It says a lot about who they are and also says a lot about their company. So,
oh, absolutely. Thank you so much. And you're right, Bob, because I do have that opportunity. And the irony is I routinely tell people I know my parents better now because I received their artifacts and all of their stories than I did when I lived with them as a child. I know so much more about them. And I'm actually in a position where I want to listen, right? Like when you're a kid, I don't know, you're a little egotistical. Like you're just running around in your own world. It's really nice to have the luxury to be ready to receive those stories and have a way to do it.
No doubt. No doubt. And the stories are much more meaningful now that you're very intentional in trying to preserve and learn. I love that about what you're doing and what the company is doing overall. So it seems like you've created not a product as much as a way or a new habit or a way of life, and one that is engaging for all people of all ages. Do you see it that way?
Yeah, absolutely. This is not something you go buy a widget and you use it 3 times and you're kind of done. This is a habit. This is something that, you know, now my daughter gives me a Mother's Day card. You can bet the first thing I do is artifact it. And I actually have her tell me about it. And I have her little voice on video and face, you know, like I am actively recording, you know, all of these things I'm collecting. My husband gave me a piece of jewelry for our anniversary. First thing I did was artifact it.
Wow.
And I included the receipt with it too. So if I lose it or I need to insure it, I've got it. But it is, and we want it to be an experience. This is something that should connect people. It should make them pause and realize, you know, I have stories. I matter. It's that very much like I have purpose, and here I am, and I don't care if you're 16 or 99. You know, we all have stories. We're all living every day, and that's exactly what we're aiming for. Is this is definitely a way of life.
So, where does this reside? Does it reside up on your website? I mean, I know that you can do all this stuff with your phones or devices, and you know, you're using that obviously as the impetus, and you don't want to keep it in your iCloud. You want to be able to consolidate it. So, you know, inquiring minds, mine being one of them, you know, once I've recorded all this stuff, where does it go? What do you do with it?
Yep. So we have a private cloud that we have on Amazon West. And so, you know, everyone has to choose somewhere to store it. And given our government background, we actually went through AWS. We talked to the chief information officer with the defense contracting and got some consultations. But we wanted something that we could trust. And so we do have it in a private cloud. And in that way, you know, you're actually accessing your artifacts wherever you are, right? My dad jokes that he now has a traveling recipe cookbook because he's artifacted all of his family recipes. And he's like, wherever I am, I can just pull up the recipe. And, you know, it's very interesting that way. But it is cloud-based and secure that way. Yes, that's where we store it.
So you mentioned a birthday card. So, you know, we all got stuff. And I'm going through right now a purging situation in my house. I mean, I've been in my home 30 years. My kids have all grown up. And, you know, my wife Susie is amazing. She's trying to, you know, figure out what is what and what are we keeping and what are we tossing. When you take that video or picture and then a video of your daughter and her reading it or giving you the message behind it, what do you do with the card? Do you toss it or do you keep it? I really want to know.
Am I going to get in trouble? I'm going to get in trouble, aren't I? For the most part, I get rid of them. I don't have the space. And frankly, what I was doing before, ultimately they would go into a bin and they go in the attic. So I wasn't even accessing them anyway. I do keep some very special ones, whether it's because it's the person that gave it to me. I'm not going to keep a card that someone just signed their name. I'm sorry, I'm not.
No, definitely not.
There's like a long message or it's particularly beautiful artwork that they made themselves. But for the most part, I'm keeping the memories and letting go of the stuff. I can't collect, you know, especially those who, you have a whole life that you've curated. I get that. But, you know, I was just at my parents in Wisconsin last week and I said, Mom, no more greeting cards. I mean, she had hundreds dating back decades and they were filling all the drawers and she's never looking at them. And I was like, we got to get through this. Let's pick the ones that are most special. We'll make sure they're accessible and we'll artifact them because, you know, then she can actually access them when she wants to. And that was our approach.
Well, you hear the music. We're at halftime here. And I'm really glad you said that because I want to pick up on that in the second half. I want to talk about that and so much more. You're listening to Health Futures Taking Stock in You. I'm your host, Bob Roth. I've got Ellen Goodwin in the studio with me from Artifcts. Stick around. We got another half. We'll be right back.
Now back to Health Futures, taking stock in you. If you have questions about your own or your loved one's future health care, call 602-264-8009. Now, here's your host, Cypress Home Care Solutions, Bob Roth.
Welcome back. You're listening to Health Futures Taking Stock in You. I'm your host, Bob Roth, and we're in our third segment. And if you're just tuning in, I have got Ellen Goodwin, co-founder and chief solution officer with a company called Artifcts, Artifcts. And you can find them at artifcts.com. Ellen, welcome back. Great to have you on.
Thank you, Bob.
Yes. So we left off talking about all this stuff and what do you do with it. And you did share with us that, you know, you purge and you get rid of it. And that's the whole point in doing this activity. And, you know, we're going through so much stuff in my own home. And, you know, my wife is pulling up stuff from the kids who, you know, 20 years ago, 25 years ago, you know, projects, scrapbooks, all the things. And, I mean, one of the scrapbooks is falling apart because it was in the garage. And if you live here in Arizona, when you get 30 days over 110 degrees, you know, the stuff starts to, you know, starts to fall apart. Let's just leave it at that, yellow and fall apart. So yeah, it's a great activity and it's a great way to get these stories out. I love it.
It absolutely is. And I have empathy with you on those scrapbooks and photo albums. I mean, it's just a reality. We've been writing about that a lot recently. It's a very popular topic. And especially because, you know what, we don't sit down with each other as much anymore. We don't live as, you know, families aren't staying living near each other as much. So you're not walking through the scrapbooks and telling them what they mean. And that becomes its own burden.
Right.
So never mind everything falling out of them.
No doubt. So for those in our audience who are living within the senior community settings, or maybe they are a caregiver, you know, how do they get started and how can Artifcts come into play for them?
Yeah, I think it's a really great tool to have at their disposal. You know, the thing is, there's two ways. It's the incoming, it's the receiving of an artifact and the sharing of an artifact, right? You can download the app, go to our website. You can create a free account, create your first 5 artifacts free. See what you think. But the idea behind it is being able to connect with others. And that might mean, you know, you're living in some awesome senior community and let's say you're in Phoenix and you have loved ones elsewhere. Maybe you're creating an artifact. You're sharing the story behind a memento you have in your home, a photo. You can send it to your loved one wherever they are and connect. And you know what happens? Everyone tells us, I send an artifact and I get a phone call or an email. And we had one resident actually tell us she was very frustrated because, well, she loves receiving cards and photos, et cetera. She pointed to a stack of photos she had on her side table where she kind of hangs out during the day. And she's like, they're becoming a problem. It's all over and it's clutter. And she said, can't they just artifact the photos and tell me about them? Because that was her other problem. I don't even understand what's happening in these photos. I just see my granddaughter 100 times.
Hey, Ellen, just real quick, I know you, and I know you well enough. You're probably moving around. I need you to find that one space where so it's not a little choppy. You sound like you're a little bit underwater. So, no, just
Is this better?
Oh, this is definitely better. So if you can go back about 10 seconds, that would be great.
All right. Well, so for care providers and others, the idea is simply capturing the stories or family, sharing the artifacts with someone they may live near or not. But the idea is maybe you have new photos that you want to share the stories behind. If you send it via artifacts, they get a notification, hey, you have a new artifact. And they can read it at their leisure versus creating more clutter and sending it in the mail.
So they can actually send it right through your website, or do they?
Absolutely. So they just pop in your email.
Wow, so you don't have to, like, cut and paste and attach. I mean, it's all done within. So your account is set up right inside of the website, and you can do everything from there?
Yep, you just sign in. And I will tell you, a lot of our folks, they do use the facial recognition. If it's a mobile phone, they don't want to worry about remembering passwords. But you'll get a notification alert, and as long as you have notifications turned on and you click it, there you go. Here's a new photo and a little video snippet, maybe, and a story about what was happening that day. That's a great way to connect.
You know what I find fascinating on your website, too, is this, you've got the members of the Arty community, the artifacts community, and you've got videos of these folks that are, you know, giving you testimonials, and then you've got some written words here. I know it must stir so much emotions, and in a very positive way, but and sometimes sad, because you're telling a story about somebody that may no longer be here, or somebody that, you know, has changed dramatically. But it really gets to all the emotions that one has by going through this entire process. It's probably very cathartic for a lot of people.
We get that a lot. We get a lot of tears, and we get a lot of, I didn't know how I was going to get through this until I discovered artifacts. And I do think, too, we had one person write in fairly recently, and she said she had lost someone very close to her. And she said that she used this as a grief tool. Essentially, she was artifacting these objects from the person she lost, and she said it was better than therapy. And I said, you might not want to tell your therapist that. And she said, oh, no, I showed my therapist my artifacts. But it was cathartic, like just having it there and thinking it through. And we can appreciate that, right? And then, you know, down the line, and she did write us back, and she said she ended up sending the artifacts to this person's close friends and family and sharing those memories with them. And I think that it's great. It's a celebration of life and who they were versus, you know, it's not a deep, dark death website or anything like that.
Well, I got to tell you, I mean, you talk about activities, right? You have kids. You know, I'm sitting across from Lauren, who does a lot of work with us. She has kids. I mean, yes, we're done the summer, but, you know, we're going to have fall break. We're going to have Thanksgiving. Mm-hmm. We're going to have Christmas. There's so much that could be done, especially, you know, with kids, you know, I'm not talking about, you know, 3 or 4 year olds. I'm talking about, you know, kids that are in middle school and high school who really understand tech, and they understand the power of devices and stuff like that. You know, for them to sit down with their parents or grandparents and have them, you know, have this activity and this connection and going through this and memorializing it, not just for them, but for all family members. What a great activity.
It is a great buffer. And there was someone, we almost put the full quote on our website, but we weren't sure. But she said, you know, now I have something to do when I go to my parents' house, because it can be awkward. You know, there can be time to fill. And, you know, you can have some of that. Or kids might, you know, they might not spend a lot of time around their grandparents and not know what to say. And this becomes what you said. It's that activity to do together. And even if they don't really understand the value in the moment, they will later, and it will be there waiting for them. And it's really a lovely experience. And, you know, frankly, one of my closer friends told me she's Marie Kondoing her parents' house using our tool.
Wow.
I was like, you know what? However you and your family gets along, that's great.
Well, what's interesting, too, for me, and, you know, because I'm in the older adult space, you know, we have lots of clients and people generally in our community that face a diagnosis of dementia or Alzheimer's. And I think the general public thinks that, wow, you know, once you get that diagnosis, you know, you start whispering and talking about that person behind their back. But they're present. They're there. And their clarity is still there. They just wane off. And, you know, knowing someone that may have just recently gotten a diagnosis, this is the time where you amp it up and you're like, okay, we got to do artifacting right now so we can grab all these stories. Because with some that may have frontal lobe dementia, it goes really fast and it affects behaviors. You know, some with, you know, other type of cognition issues, it's a little bit slower. But what a great thing for those families that have a loved one that have been faced with this diagnosis.
Yeah, and you called it right, Bob. This is not, they're suddenly not who they were, right? And I do think there's always a race against time, right? I do tell people my artifacts are my insurance policy. I get hit by a bus tomorrow, my daughter might know me by my artifacts. But people with dementia, they're still ever present. And as many people realize, it's usually the longer-term memory that goes later. The short-term memory becomes more difficult more rapidly. But the other thing about it, artifacting is like an art, right? You can exercise the brain by virtue of not just the recall, but the crafting of the story. And that is great for engaging people versus like sitting them in front of a TV or staring at, you know, a puzzle or whatever it is. But like, this is a way to engage the brain
so
creatively,
true.
Which has a very different effect.
You know, we had a dementia specialist with me for a number of years, and she's since moved on to greener pastures, and she and I are still very close, and that's exactly what she did when she'd walk into someone's home that had dementia or Alzheimer's. She'd say, you know, because part of what we do is home safety evaluation, we would go through the home, and she would have the person take them through it, and she goes, oh, this is your family picture, tell me about your family, and exactly what you're talking about, but we never, we didn't record it, you know, it was enough for us, but you know, to think that we could have memorialized that for the family and have that everlasting and evergreen, that would have been really cool. Well, as you can hear, music's up. We're down three. We got one more to go. I understand that you recently had a success for some kind of challenge. So I'm going to lean in a little bit on this fourth segment and learn a little bit about what you're doing, and you can fill us in.
I'm in.
You bet. You're listening to Health Futures, taking stock in you. I'm your host, Bob Roth. We're down three segments. We got one more to go. We got Ellen Goodwin from Artifcts. Stick around. We'll be right back.
Now back to Health Futures, taking stock in you. If you have questions about your own or your loved one's future health care, call 602-264-8009. Now, here's your host, Cypress Home Care Solutions, Bob Roth.
Welcome back. You're listening to Health Futures, taking stock in you. I'm your host, Bob Roth. We're in our fourth segment here. If you're just tuning in, I have got Ellen Goodwin in the studio with me. She's the co-founder and chief solutions officer for Artifcts. Got a little hook taking us in. You like that, don't you? Gotta like the who. Listen, Ellen, we've talked about a lot of different things, and I really love what you're doing and the activities that you do provide for families, for caregivers, to help memorialize one's life, their possessions, their recipes, anything is really fascinating. I love what you're doing, and I hope you continue to gain traction, but you recently got some really nice recognition. Congratulations on your success with the Massachusetts eHealth Healthy Aging Sandbox Challenge. And I understand Artifcts is partnering with UMass Chan Medical School on research related to dementia. And we were just talking about that. So can you fill us in?
Oh, it's my pleasure. And thank you. We were thrilled. We view this as an important and to Artifcts. It's not a pivot, right? We still want to help you with all the stuff, whether it's organizing it, moving it, downsizing, decluttering, inventory for insurance, estate planning. All of that is wonderful. But what we are going to do at UMass with our grant that we received is a small initial study to look at whether we can use Artifcts, since they can each include audio and video, as a means to digitally scan for the biomarkers in the voices that indicate that there may be some mild cognitive impairment or even dementia.
I've heard of this stuff. Tell me more, please, because I've heard I've heard they've got that down where they can discern from someone's inflection or their voice or the way they talk, they can discern. That's fascinating to me.
It's amazing, frankly. I mean, this is modern science at its best, right? So UMass Chan Medical School already has a functional, highly predictive digital screening tool that they've developed. But what they've been doing is with this machine learning model is based on cohorts that they interview every couple years as part of another study. And they have to do a lot of cleaning of the data to pick up the interviewer's voice and the interview voice. They only get to talk to them every couple of years. It's very intensive. And it requires that in-person presence to participate. Mm. What we're going to do is take that same machine learning model, but modify it with Artifcts as the input. Because, look, if it's fun and you're connecting and having a great time Artifcting, if it could have this amazing benefit where you can say, I'm going to choose these five recent Artifcts, scan them, and see how I'm doing, that would be amazing, because then you remove the barrier to actually be there in person, which has a travel cost, a time cost, a financial cost, and lower that barrier so people are like, let me see how I'm doing, right? And you can do it long before you might otherwise. You know, people talk 20 or 30 years before you're diagnosed. These brain changes are already happening. Let's push down that barrier to screening so that people are checking in more often.
I love it. I really do. I think that is so cool. I just want to find out, how did you find out about this? Did Heather or you see this, you know, challenge happen? Did they come to you? How did this come about?
I think we first heard about it. So Artifcts is a member of the Age Tech Collaborative with AARP. So the day we launched, our second birthday is coming up in a few weeks, but the day we launched 2 years ago, we actually pitched to AARP, and we got in to their innovation labs, and we went to a program there. And I think we first heard about what's the short name. You gave the beautiful long name, but it's called MIHI. I think we first heard about you there. And so we had to apply and go through a pitch competition, and we became a finalist. And then in June, we flew to MIT, where we had the final pitch competition, and we presented our idea. And I'll be blunt, people were shocked. They really thought that we would stick with the more well-known reminiscence therapy. What does it mean to reminisce, and how is it good for the brain to look at photos and remember, which is a credible area for science. But we wanted to look at a different challenge that people are facing in terms of brain health, which is purely the diagnosis and frankly, the fear that goes with it, and how can we get ahead of it? Because dementia is not a foregone conclusion. We do not have to get dementia as we age. If we can pay attention to brain health earlier and make smarter food choices and lifestyle choices, we can keep our brains healthier. And we wanted to get out ahead of it.
I love it. I absolutely love it. What do you got cooking? Anything else like this? This is so innovative. I'm telling you,
it's really exciting. Yeah, we have a busy fall ahead, Bob. We will be at the National Association of Specialty and Senior Move Managers Conference. We'll be presenting there. We're also going to be presenting for Save the Photos Month next month. And obviously October is Family History Month, which is very busy for us. And then, come January, we're going to actually go with AARP to CES in Las Vegas, the Consumer Electronics Show. And we'll be on the floor there with, a couple hundred thousand people that visit CES every year. But we'll be sharing Artifcts with this crowd there as well in Vegas.
Wow. No, I think that's all fascinating. And two, if you haven't thought about it, November is National Family Caregiving Month. And, maybe there's a way we can tie in Artifcts with that, because those family caregivers are the ones that are the unsung heroes that are making the ultimate sacrifice, and they're all looking for things to do with their loved ones. And, you know, there's only so much, you know, Gunsmoke you can watch and Wheel of Fortune, right? So, I mean, to do something like this, it would be really, really cool. You know,
it absolutely would. We'll connect on that.
We've got about a minute left. And, you know, I always like to ask my guests, is there a question I haven't asked, or is there a lasting thought you would like to leave our listeners before we say goodbye?
You know, I think it's really one to say, whether or not you use artifacts, take a good look around you in your home and think about what's there and what's telling your stories. One of my favorite ways to say it is, like, if you look around, what's the favorite moment in your house? I have a jar full of sand. That's my favorite moment, and people would think I'm crazy. But take that moment for yourself. And I think no matter what you do, take a moment, call a loved one, and share a story. That's what I would say. We need human connection.
Oh, I love that. Absolutely love that. Well, listen, Ellen, it's great to visit with you. I hope to see you again. I don't know if you're going to Leading Age like you did last year. But if not,
I'm not sure we'll be there this year. Yeah.
But if not, then, you know, if your travels come this way, we'd love to visit with you. And I love the work that you and Heather are doing. It's hard to believe that you're coming up on a birthday. You said it's been 2 years?
2 years on August 26th.
Wow. You guys have accomplished so much. I am so grateful to have you on and grateful for the work you're doing.
Pleasure.
Keep up
it's
the great work. Stay cool, because I know it's been equally hot there in Austin, Texas. And make it a great day. Have a great weekend. We'll be back next Friday. Thank you.
There's no place like home. You've been listening to Bob Roth's Health Futures. If you have questions about your own or your loved one's future health care, call Cypress Home Care Solutions at 602-264-8009. That's 602-264-8009. Or visit cypresshomecare.com. Be sure to join Health Futures with Bob Roth every Friday at noon, right here on Money Radio 1510 and 105.3 FM.